So far in the course, we've talked about how to create an XML document, how to do schemas to validate them, how to know if we're well-formed and all that sort of thing. Now let's totally shift sides. Keep in mind, XML was designed simply to make the data self-describing so that when I hand it to you, you don't have to come back and ask me any more questions about the data. The data describes itself and you can simply look through it and determine what you need from it. Now, if you need more data or different data, yeah, you got to come back to me or my database. But XML makes it self-describing. That also makes it possible to trade data. And now that we know about namespaces, it's very possible for me to have a tag named cost, you to have a tag named cost, and us yet still differentiate which tag came from who, and then know exactly what that tag actually means. So XML, in a nutshell, is concerned about the description of the data, or the data maintaining its meaning. Now, we've got a new problem with XML, and that is XML is not pretty. Now, while we can read this and look at it, you don't want to put this kind of data on your database, on your websites, and you don't want your users having to read it, because when we put that in a browser, and I'll just double click this and open it in Internet Explorer, notice what you're going to get. That's the way it shows up in Internet Explorer. Well, this is not going to work at all, because what we want is some sort of pretty presentation. Now, think back to HTML. The original idea with HTML was to make the data simply appear in a browser in a readable format. Didn't have to be pretty, didn't have to have any flash and pop or indents or anything. Just put it out there so scientific nerds and government military types and so forth could read this. And I don't mean either one of those derogatory. When you're in an academic situation doing a study, or you're in a military situation, you really don't care if it's H2 or H3 or whether it's green or blue. You need the data. And that's where the whole web world came from. So then, as commercial interest moved into the internet, it became more important to make it easy to read, make it pretty to read, make it pleasant to read. And so we started down this path of adding all this functionality into the tags in HTML to give us all sorts of things, different foreground and background colors, different font types, and so forth. And what ended up happening is our markup language became just absolutely littered and destroyed with processing instructions. And so everybody started to figure out real quick, hey, wait a minute, this is not helping us. Go to the web and open up almost any web page and go to View Source. And what you're actually looking at in most cases is HTML that was generated by a web server, but you'll still see a lot of processing instructions in there, more so a lot more processing instructions than there is data usually. So we've got a new problem with XML. Yes, it maintains our data, but since it has zero, absolutely no presentation information in it, all it can do is simply expose itself in the raw XML form. And this is not user-friendly reading. You don't want to scan a document with 1,500 names in it looking for a particular person, not in this format. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to use one of two complementary technologies that are available to us. One's been around a while, one's new, to work with the presentation of XML data and to make it look prettier in the browser. So that's where we're headed in the next few videos.